Hello everyone and welcome back to what has been a while. It is our Nottingham Forest career mode and we pick off from episode 7 where we came out of the transfer window with a left back and no money in the bank. So yeah, without further ado, let's get into this episode and carry on and hopefully get Nottingham Forest out of this league. Before we do get into the episode, however, I do want to let everyone know that I apologise for the series being on halt for all but a week. I did come down with a bit of a cold, so I didn't really fancy recording, especially when I was coughing every other second. So, yeah, that is the reason why the episodes haven't been coming out. But I'm back now, and I'm ready to play this save. It's been a while. It's been a whole week. Can't really remember what happened last time. So I'll tell you what, let's refresh our memories. Ah yes, I remember now. So as you can see, we played Leeds, Blackburn, Reading, Bristol City and Wigan. A very balanced month actually. Two losses, two wins and a draw. So again, I can't really remember these games off the top of my head, but I do remember that we lost the FA Cup game, which does mean we are now out of the FA Cup and it is just the Championship we are focusing on. We did lose to Leeds after being 2-0 of them at the first half, if I remember correctly. So, yeah, that was a bit of a sour one as well. Drew to Reading, who, again, probably should have won, but we still managed to beat Bristol City and Wigan, so at least we still managed to get 6 points from a possible 15. Maths. anyway, this episode will consist of us playing 5 games. Those games consist of Birmingham, Brentford, West Brom, Preston, and ending it off with another derby day against Derby. Yeah, very, very tough month. But, I mean, Brentford, West Brom, Preston and Derby are all pretty solid teams. So I am expecting tough games. Birmingham, on the other hand, I believe they're in a decent season, but I reckon we can get past them. But yeah, it's all about trying to get these points past these certain teams. And most importantly, if not beating any of the other teams, beating Derby, because I don't fancy losing a Derby day, especially after we won the first one. So yeah, without further ado, let's get into the first game of the episode, which will see us playing Birmingham away from home. Before we get into the game against Birmingham, one thing has just came through the inbox, and that is Tendai Dirikwa will be going on loan to Preston. Yeah, he hasn't been playing much for us. We have got Yanko and Byram at the club still, and I've been using them a lot more. Even though Tendai Dirikwa has been a pretty solid player for us, I do feel like he does deserve a bit of game time. So I'm happy for him to go to Preston. It's a Championship club and it's a good club. So hopefully he can find a bit of game time and most importantly, come back here after it, maybe even challenge for the first team. But anyway, it's goodbye for the rest of the season, Dirikwa, and hopefully you have a good time at Preston. Another quick little interruption before we get into our game against Birmingham. One thing I've just come across is the English transfer window roundup from the Premier League this season, and it's a weird one. Rodrigo's gone to Man United from Valencia for £61 million, which is something I wouldn't see happening in real life, but oh well. Ryan Bertrand going to Arsenal. It's plausible. I mean, weird, but plausible. And William Jose, who I have never heard of, is also going to Arsenal for £40 million. So, yeah, an elite striker and a fullback for Arsenal. Perhaps they're challenging for that title. One thing we will do after the Birmingham game, perhaps, is check in on all the leagues and see where everyone is. But, yeah, biggest spenders are Man United, £93 million. So they bought someone else as well as Rodriguez. And most active are Peterborough, who have signed 7 players so far. So, good on them. And here we are, finally. It is match day and it is the first game of the episode. We will be playing Birmingham at St. Andrew's Trillion Trophy Stadium. Bloody hell, say that 10 times really quickly. Yeah, Grabban is still playing up front for us. Some of you may have noticed. I did make a promise in the last episode that if he scored, we would play him a couple more games. And surprisingly to everyone, he scored. Not the best of goals, but a goal that didn't include him being passed to by the other team or a penalty that came off the goalkeeper and went in. So yeah, we'll give him another go. We'll see what he can do. If he doesn't perform as well in this game, he probably will be benched for the next few games, mainly because they are tougher games. But yeah, without further ado, the lineups the same as usual. Obviously, we're missing Joe Lolly now as he has gone to West Brom. So hopefully that doesn't affect us too much in the long run. And hopefully we can still get goals in our games without him. But yeah, let's get into the game and let's get 3 points. And here we are, Grabban to kick us off, and we are to enter the first half with the ball. Highlight now, the first highlight of the first half. Nottingham Forest to pick up the ball. Are they going to score from this highlight? Robinson to Cash. To Robinson, who delivers a ball in. Ball lost. Birmingham now have a chance, and they have played Vassal through, who shoots, but it's saved by Smith. Corner to come. Highlight now for Forest as the ball is delivered in. Hefele finds Gil Diaz, and he has scored. Bit delayed there on my commentary because I didn't understand what was going on. But nonetheless, Goncalves delivers in a good free kick. Troublesome for the keeper originally. Diaz has a header. Saved. Hefele brings it back to Diaz, who scores. Anyway, it's 1-0 and we haven't had a single highlight. Another highlight now for Forest in the 39th minute. Robinson to find Osborne. Osborne to shoot, and the keeper shit his pants, I think, a bit there. So those were the highlights from the first half. As you can see, we are being dominated in terms of them getting shots off on goal. 9 shots to 3 on target, whether it's our 2 shots to 1 on target, and one of them being a goal, is obviously winning us this game. However, we have got a slight advantage in possession. But yeah, both teams right now probably aren't playing the best. Hopefully, though, we can extend our lead a little bit further, as I do feel that if Birmingham bring on a better striker than whoever it is they've got up front, they might actually get a goal. So yeah, let's go into the second half. And we kick off the second half with Daniel Lazure coming on for Jack Robinson, who is knackered. Highlight now for Forest. Lazure to pick up the ball from a throw-in. Jakob giving it to Yates, who has just come on for Cash. Osborne to Yates. Back to Osborne. To Jakob, back to Yates. Some lovely triangle passing going on here. Shot attempt from Yates fails. Forrest looking to play out from the back. It's worked. Lazure has found some space. Can't quite get the ball in. Yates picks it up again, though. Osborne back to Lazure. Can he get the cross in this time? No, but the keeper spills it where he probably could have caught it, and it's led to a corner. Can Forrest do something from this corner in the 80th minute? Goncalves to bring it in. Oh, and Figueredo sends it just over the bar. Corner now. Last minute for Birmingham. Smith to pick it up. The amount of time has been played, and that is the final whistle here at Birmingham's ground, which I can't remember because it's so goddamn long. Anyway, yeah, that's full time. I do think we were a little bit lucky to win this game. Again, 10 shots, 2 on target, and one of them happened to go in. It's a rarity that we get a game like this, so I'll take it, obviously. But I don't know, I definitely feel like Birmingham should have had something from this game, maybe even a draw, because they definitely played a lot better. Yeah, we might have had a bit more of possession, but that means nothing when you're getting the shots on the goal. So yeah, I'll take this 3 points, and hopefully the team will play a lot better compared to how they played today. Before we get into our game against Brentford, I thought it best we actually remind ourselves of where we are in the league, because I did actually forget. That game against Birmingham has put us second, and as you can see, everyone has played 30 games, so the league table is standing as it is. We are currently second, 3 points behind Leeds, who are currently top. I have no doubt there's a reason why they're top, but we won't talk about that, eh? Eh? And here we are. It is the game against Brentford. We are playing our first game at home of the episode. Our second game, however, of the episode altogether. Yeah, Brentford. Not entirely sure where they are in the league. Can't really remember anymore, but I'm pretty sure they're in the top half. So this is going to be a game that we definitely need to win. And hopefully it's a game that we can get 3 points from a bit more comfortably than last game. But yeah, let's get right into it and see how things go. And here we are kicking off the first half at the City Ground. Highlight now in the first half, 20 minutes in. Mopy has played through and he has scored. Brentford are 1-0 up. We've been dominating Brentford for the first 20 minutes, but that's all it takes. Just one incredible ball from Barbet over everyone and to Mopy or Mapai. I don't know how you say it. And yeah, 1-0 down. Not the best to start. Let's hope we can recover. Highlight now for Forest. Byram to have a throw-in. Trying to do exactly what Barbet did. Can't quite pull it off. Brentford now have the ball and are looking to do something with it. Henry to Barbet. Metham picking it up, looking to play it to the wing. He's successful in that play. And it is another goal. Sergi Canos has scored. 10 minutes later after Mopy has scored. Yeah. Great. 2-0. Another highlight now just before the game ends. Forrest looking to get a goal back just before the first half ends. Diaz puts a cross in. Osborne volleys and nearly scores a wonder goal. So we go into the second half after I gave him a bollocking. Let's hope that they can draw this game up like they used to do. What a fucking clearance. Corner to come from that clearance. Soudani nearly scoring. Gil Diaz to shoot. Can't quite get it over the goal line. Highlight now. Forrest having the ball. Spreading it wide to Diaz. Diaz looking to run. Play through Soudani, who shoots right at the keeper. Another highlight now. Goncalves to deliver a ball, and Figueiredo has scored. He picks up the ball and he's running back to the centre spot. It's a good start from the boys. 4 minutes in and we've managed to get a goal out of this game. We just need another one and then I'm happy. Don't necessarily want to win this game, seeing as Brentford have been dominating us. Highlight now for Forrest. Lazio picking it back up. Osborne to find Cash, who's just come on. Osborne giving it to Figueiredo. Figueiredo switching it right to Byron. Byron with a great touch. Playing through Goncalves. And it's 2-2. Come on. 65 minutes in and it is 2-2. Can we make this 3-2? I would like the win, but I'm not necessarily looking for one. I'm just looking to get a point out of this game. Come on, Forrest. What a cross and what a goal. Anyway, it's 2-2 at the City Ground. Another highlight now in the 85th minute. Forrest to get a throw in. Diaz shoots and oh my god! Gil Diaz has scored! It's 3-2 at the City Ground. Come on! Oh, I feel like I'm celebrating a bit prematurely, but it was just such a good goal. Byron playing through Gil Diaz. Look at all that space they gave him and just look at that thunder strike. Oh yes, I was definitely going to go say something else then. But I just tried not to. Anyway, 3-2. Free kick now for Goncalves. It is nearly time to end the game. And it is the end of the game. And we have brought it back from what seemed to be a dreadful loss. I've got to give all the players credit here. But yeah, what a game. Anyway, that is full time here at City Ground, and what a game to watch. We were 2-0 down in the first half, and goals from Tobias Figueiredo, Diogo Goncalves, and Gil Diaz send us through with 3 points. Come on! So here we are in our third game of the episode against West Brom at the Hawthorns. Yeah, a lot of the games currently are quite congested, so there has been a smidgen of rotation. Danny Fox is playing centre-back this game because he has complained about his game time and wants a stint in the first team, and I've given it to him, seeing as he is a highly influential player, and if he believes that he could do something, then why not? And also, considering that we've got so many games next to each other, it does make sense to do a bit of rotation, especially around that defensive line. Anyway, Ryan Yates will also be playing this game alongside Jakub and Tashdidis. Cash making his debut for us on the wing. I've decided to play him on the wing, seeing as he's basically our backup right winger now after Joe Lolley's gone. And speaking of Joe Lolley, we are playing West Brom, who is now his new team. So yeah, hopefully he doesn't score past us. And yeah, if he does, it's going to be a bit salty. You'll definitely see the salt shaker on the screen, that's for sure, if he does score. So yeah, anyway, without further ado, let's get into this game. And yeah, hopefully come away with a win. Or a draw, preferably one of the two. Duh. So as you can see, these are the lineups for both teams. Dwight Gale being up front for West Brom, Jay Rodriguez on the wing. It does put shivers down the spine. Joe Lolley is on the bench as well, however, he has not started against us. So yeah. Also, is that Stephen Davis? I think it is. Yeah. I'm afraid. And here we are kicking off the first half at the Hawthorns. Highlight now in the first half, 20 minutes in. Dwight Gale's been sent through and he hasn't scored somehow. What the shit? Anyway, corner for West Brom. Davis to put it in. Oh, and that is the first half. Yes, there was only one highlight during that first half. It's always fun to only have one highlight in a half. But rightly so, we've been playing dog shit. We've had a lot of the ball and done nothing with it. They've had minimal amounts of the ball and made me shit my pants on two occasions. So yeah, best try and sort this out, eh? And here we are going into the second half. Hopefully we can pick up a goal. Highlight now for West Brom. Jesus Christ, tackles are shitting me up because we've already on three yellow cards and I don't know what's going to happen. Livermore picks the ball back up from a counter-attack. West Brom looking to do something from his counter-attack. Bong running through. Passing it back to Field. Livermore to Davis, and what a fucking awful shot that's gone in. Davis has scored from an assist from Livermore, and it is currently 1-0. Only 1 minute into the second half. God damn it. Highlight again for West Brom. Corner comes in, nothing comes from it. Counter-attack potential now for Forrest. Gil Diaz sending it through to Sudani, who, as per usual, lets me down and doesn't actually run onto it. West Brom have the ball back. Are they going to make it a 2-0 lead? Johnston sending it over to Gale. Can't quite pull it off. Diaz picks up the ball. Just came on for Goncalves. Diaz shoots. Johnston with a good save. Corner still to come. Osborne to deliver. Osborne delivers it in. Cleared by Rodriguez for another corner. Highlight now. Danny Fox to deliver a ball in. Johnston catches. Highlight is still to continue. Johnston kicks it out to Yanko, who's just come on. Fox. Send it to Sudani. Can't quite find it. Cash gets the ball. Doesn't quite find that either. Yanko picks it up. Delivers it to Panagiotis. Panagiotis to Osborne. Osborne to Yates. Yates switches it to Robinson. Can Robinson get a good cross in? Sudani scored. It's 1-1. Fucking suck it. Yes. Joe Lolly is on the pitch as well, may I remind everyone. And yeah, I just didn't want him to come away with a win after being on the pitch. But Sudani has levelled us. And oh my God, it took him a while. But yes, come on, 1-1. Free kick now for West Brom. And nothing comes from it as Jay Rodriguez sends it behind the goal. And the referee's whistle has blown. And that is it. It's full time. And it is a 1-1 draw here at the whatever stadium it was. I believe it was the Hawthorns. I can't remember. Yeah. Thank fuck. Woo! Anyway, yeah, that is full time. And as you can see from the match stats, oh my God, I don't know how we didn't win. Yeah. Had a lot of shots, did West Brom. However, Dwight Gale did have a poor performance. So that's partially the reason as to why I think they didn't actually get more goals than they should have. 13 shots for us, 6 on target. So we definitely had a better shot percentage than West Brom did. That's before. And most importantly, we had so much possession. And again, we just didn't do not... We didn't do enough. We didn't do enough. But nonetheless, Danny Fox getting best performance on the team so far. After wanting to have a stint in the first team, so yeah, I'm happy with him. And to be honest, I'm all right with that. I'm all right with that result. So yeah, not as best as the Brentford game, but anyway, let's move into our fourth game of the episode, which will be against someone that isn't Derby, because I know they're our last opponent. So yeah, very professional. So here we are, the penultimate game of the episode, and it is against Preston? Deepdale in the Skybet Championship. Yeah. Oh, God. So far we're unbeaten in this episode, but I don't know. We got lucky last game. A bit more rotation this game, one of which I am worried about, and that is Pantilimon in goal. So, yeah. And Bridcut at Deep Lion Playmaker. So, I don't know. I have a funny feeling we're going to lose this game, but... Oh well, let's just hope we don't lose the game to Derby, eh? Anyway, without further ado, let's get into this game and hopefully prevent Pantilimon from moaning at me for not playing enough games. He hasn't yet, but I know he will. I know he will. I know what this game's like. Anyway, let's go. Okay, so before we get into the game against Preston, one thing I have just realised is not only... Do Preston have Callum Hudson-Odoi, which I believe they have for a while anyway, but I completely forgot about it. They also have Plymouth Argyle's talisman, Graham Carey. So, yeah, I'm quite surprised. I didn't expect that one. They've also got Ben Davies as well, who's, you know, all right, but he's no Graham Carey. So, anyway, yeah, without further ado, let's get into the game and hopefully beat them. And most importantly, beat Graham Carrier because he left Argyle. And here we are, Preston kicking off their first half at their home. Corner now for Preston, and Paul Huntington has scored at the far post. Yeah, I don't feel like we should lose this game. I'm going to say it right now because a lot of their players are quite tired, whether it's ours. A lot of ours are quite fit, so I don't know. I have a funny feeling that we can win this game. Highlight now for Forrest, looking to get a goal back. Yanko playing it to Diaz. Diaz shoots, nearly curls it into the top left corner. Robinson with a great touch. Wow. Oh, Diaz flicking it behind him and running through. Can he play through to Grabban? Grabban! Why? Corner. Osborne to pick it back up again for it to lead to another corner. Osborne delivering it. Grabban still missing. And that is the first half. And long story short, we're absolutely shitting on them, but not getting anything from it. So I'm going to give the team a quick bollocking, and we're going to go into the second half and hopefully actually score and preferably win. We kick off the second half looking to equalise and perhaps get ahead. Goal kick for Preston. Ball one back. Grabban, pay it down to Goncalves. Goncalves shoots greedily, but then again, Grabban would have probably missed. Anyway, another highlight ensues. Bridka giving it to Fox. Figueredo to Osborne. Osborne switching over to Goncalves. Goncalves trying to find Yates. Can't quite find him. Preston on the counter-attack. Graham Carey. Oh, oh, we're 2-0 down after Graham Carey scored his 7th goal of the season. I don't believe that's a Preston thing, that's just in general, but who knows. Anyway, definitely was a poor decision for me to put Pantillam on goal, but who knows, let's see if we can make this 2. Free kick now, and oh my god, Carey nearly scored again. Forest looking to at least get a goal, so it doesn't look like we've been completely shat on today. And somewhat shafted, because we're playing... Oh, Grabban, Grabban, please. Oh, Grabban. Why are you so shit, Grabban? Corner. Grabban! Fuck me! It took him 4 shots, but he's finally fucking scored. Oh my god, let's just watch that back, shall we? Osborne delivers a ball in. Grabban, shot number 1. Grabban, shot number 2. Shot number 3. Shot number fucking 4. And he still hits the keeper and it goes in. Jesus! Anyway, 2-1. 93rd minute. Forrest looking to equalise. Bridcut to play it to Osborne. Fucking had to save it, didn't you? Oh no, it's gonna be a loss. Oh, fuck. Oh, Graham, why? Why, Graham? Ah. Anyway, that is full time. And as you can see, we've just lost to Preston. I don't see it as a loss to Preston, though. I see it as a loss to Graham fucking Carey. And yeah, I'm going to have trouble sleeping at night knowing that that bastard scored past me. Leaves Argyle and scores past me. A manager who supports... Oh, I'm fuming. Anyway, yeah, worst performance on our team, Sadianko, which doesn't surprise me because he's been quite up and down for us during this whole season. He's definitely someone I can't see me loaning again. But who knows, who knows. Anyway, that's put an end to our unbeaten run. And it does put me in a bit of worry before the Derby game, but who knows, things can change. And one thing's for certain, Pantillamon's not going in goal against Derby. Anyway, let's move on to that Derby game. And here we are, the final game of the episode and the final game of this month at City Ground. We will be playing Derby in our biggest Derby slash rivalry known to Nottingham Forest. And yeah, last time we beat them, and we beat them quite well, and I'm pretty sure we only had 10 men when we beat them. This time, however, it's different. We've come off a loss. Yeah, I reckon we can win it, but who knows? Anything can happen in the game of football, and anything can happen on this game. But yeah, without further ado, we've gone back to somewhat the same squad that we had at the start of this episode, hoping to get us those 3 points and get us back in that second place spot, because we have dropped to third since our last game. But anyway, enough talk from me, and let's go kick Derby's ass, or they kick our ass, I don't know anymore. And here we are kicking off the first half at home. Highlight now for Derby. Brooks to Bryson, to Bogle. Bogle looking to run inside to play through Waghorn. And we're 1-0 down, 7 minutes in. Not the best of starts. But I'm not deterred. I'm not deterred. Come on, Forrest, come on. Corner kick now from Forrest. And Sudani's just missed the top left corner. Highlight for Derby. Shrivella playing it to Mount. Mount gets the ball back. Lazio picks it up from a pass from Mount. The counter-attack has begun. Lazio playing it through to Sudani, and what a goal and what a ball. Lazio getting what may be his first assist in Nottingham Forest colours. But yes, what a bit of play. All credit goes to Lazio, I believe. Sudani with a good finish, but Lazio picking that pass out, running up the pitch and finding Sudani with another great pass. Anyway, it's 1-1. Come on. So it is currently 1-1 at half-time, and yeah, it's a very balanced game. One thing Derby do have is a lot of the possession, but one thing they don't have is the goals to make up for that possession. So, yeah, I'm not too worried about them so far, but they're definitely having a worse time than us. So hopefully we can just get that extra goal, get ahead, and, yeah, win this Derby, because I don't really fancy ending it on a Derby loss. So come on. Bad pass from Bryson leads to Osborne to try and hit it wide. Couldn't quite pull it off, though. Forrest still have the ball. Gil Diaz sending it through to Goncalves, who shoots. Oh, Goncalves is having such a bad run of form of late. I mean, he's on a 6.2. Throw in now for Forrest. Panagiotis playing it over to Hefele. Hefele sends it over. Couldn't quite get it to someone. Mount picks it up. Derby now have the ball, looking to get another goal. Yates, though, with a good tackle. Derby still have the ball, and they've played it through to Marriott. Is Marriott going to find someone? Oh, God, he nearly did. Smith, though, with a good save. Highlight still continuing. Cash playing it through to Sudani. Oh, and it's saved by Carson. Bloody hell, what an up and down highlight. Osborne for a corner. Playing it wide to Cash. Cash back to Osborne. Osborne to Hefele, to Panagiotis, who shoots. Derby now on the fucking counter-attack. Ah! Oh, thank God. Highlight now for Derby. Byram tried to tackle and it didn't succeed. Bogle picks up the ball. Derby still have the ball and it's dangerous. Ball cleared. Derby still have it, though. Ball spread wide. Lazure clears it. Gives it to Cash. Cash to Grabban. Grabban giving it back to Cash. Good old give and go. Ball trying to go in. Another fucking counter-attack. Oh, my God. Waghorn to send it in, and Brooks has scored. Ah! Fuck sakes. I need a better fucking keeper. I mean, it's not really the keeper's fault, but I mean, 2.5 star. If I had a 3.5 star, I might have fucking been able to save that. Holy shit. Ah. 2-1. And that is full time at the City Ground. And we have ended this episode. Not the same way we started it. We are coming off of a loss in the Derby. Again. Is it deserved? I don't know. Very even game, I suppose. So anyone could have took it. But nonetheless, we probably should have beaten them. They're not having a good run of form. And anyway, 2-1 at the City Ground. So to keep it short and sweet, that is the end of the episode. Ending it off with a loss to Derby. Didn't end it the way we started it, but nonetheless, we are still third in the league and we are still 4 points clear of the bottom of the playoff spots. So it could be worse. It could be a lot worse. However, nonetheless, I definitely think Leeds have pulled away from us here, and it looks like they're probably going to be the victors of this league going by their current form. But there's still plenty more games to play. I mean, what, 12 more games to go. So it is still all to play for. I mean, that's 36 points up for grabs if I was to win every game from now. But obviously I'm not going to, because I'm going to beat the teams who are doing really well. And then I'm going to lose to the teams who are like bottom of the table, because that's just how I've been playing so far as a manager. But anyway, I said I'd keep it short and sweet. As you can see, we are third in the league with Preston, Bristol City and Sheffield United. And even now Derby up our arse. And yeah, we've got to make sure that we can pull ahead of them, preferably soon rather than later, because I don't want to leave this down to the wire. Anyway, Blackburn and Leeds make up the top spots, whilst Birmingham, Bolton and Hull, Birmingham being a new entry into that relegation zone after Reading have pulled themselves out, make up the relegation zone. Anyway, that is the end of this episode, and I hope you guys have enjoyed it. Again, I apologize for the rate of which I am uploading these. I will try and get one out every couple of days or so, because they do actually take quite a while to edit. So, yeah, but I am still enjoying it. Don't you worry about that, and I will finish this season. And who knows what we'll do from there. I guess that'll be a decision for the final episode of this season. Anyway, as I was saying, if you enjoy the episode, please do leave a like. It does let me know if you guys are enjoying it. And leave a comment for suggestions, what you think I should do, if there's anything you think I should do to help the team, or for the episodes in general, because at the end of the day, it's you guys who watch them. I simply make them entertaining for you, and if they're not entertaining, then we do have a problem. So, yeah. But that is it from me, and that is it from Forrest, and we shall see you in episode 9. See you later.